In this video, I'm going to show you how to do if-then-else conditional logic in your make scenarios. We're going to look at the if function, the if-empty function, and the switch function and module. If we haven't met yet, my name is Andy, and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. I do that through my online community and on one-on-one co-building calls. Information about both is in the description. So we're going to start by talking about the if function. And so the if function gives you the opportunity to evaluate a condition and determine if it is true or false. If it is true, you can output one value. If it's false, you can output another. I'm also going to show you that you don't always have to have a true or false value. You can have a list of other kind of values, and these are called truthy or falsy. So let me show you what that looks like right here. So I've got a module set up here, and I've just hard-coded some things in here to show you how this works. So here is our if function. So it starts with if, and then you're going to put the value you want to consider and see if it's true or false. Next, you're going to put the value you want to output if it's true. And last, you're going to output the value if it's false. So that's what these are right here. So in this case, we say if this is true and we're putting in the true Boolean value, then output true, otherwise output false. And this is going to output true. So this one is if false. So I've just taken the same setup and I put false in there to show you how that works. You would not put true or false in there. You would put an equation or some sort of function in there that you want to evaluate to see if it's true or false. We'll get more into that in a second. All right, so here's where we get into the truthy, falsy stuff. So if you put in a null value, the null value is one of those falsy values. It's going to render as false in an if-then statement. So will a blank value. If you put a positive or a negative in here, either one is going to evaluate as true. If you put a zero in there, it will be false. So let me run this and let you see. There's not any values in here to map. We're just going to right-click and run this module only. All right, so not surprisingly, my if true came out true, or I put the actual true value in there. Same for false, came out false. If it's null, so I had no value in there, that's false. And if it's blank, it's false. If it's a positive number or a negative number, it is true. And if it's zero, it's false. These other options, these truthy, falsy options, are not in the make documentation. This is probably not new information if you have a development background, but if you're new to make, this is really helpful to know that if you pass a null or blank, it's going to be false. And if you pass any kind of number other than zero, it'll be true. Let's move on to a more advanced step here. So I'm going to go right here, and I've got some values set up here. So I have length, and I want to show you why I have length here first before we jump into the length. I am down here in an if statement, and I want to evaluate whether or not a variable is equal to 10 characters. So I have this length function inside of my if function. Again, remember, we're trying to evaluate a true false or some of those other cases. But in this case, I want to know true or false. Is the length of my text 10 characters? And if it is, we're going to output the word 10. And if it's not, we're going to output the word not 10. So let's run that. All right. So we had our length was 19. So that is not equal to 10. So you can see here, my if length equals 10 is not 10. That is the result I came back with. So right here, this is 19. And so when we evaluated our length inside of this if statement, is length equal to 10? It was not equal to 10. So it output not 10. All right. So let's go down and look at this next one. Now I have a length right here, and I'm saying if it is greater than or equal to 10, that is my condition I want to evaluate as true or false. If it's greater than or equal to 10, then it's going to say 10 plus. Otherwise, it's going to say less than 10. All right, so if we run that, Again, our length is 19. So when we say, is this greater than or equal to 10? Our result is going to be 10 plus. So that did evaluate it as greater than or equal to 10. So I hope you're starting to see these if functions are looking for a true false or one of these truthy falsy options we talked about at the beginning. All right, so next we're going to look at a contains option. So if we open this up, I have separated out, like I did before, I've separated out our true false, and I'm going to say, does this contain LAB and RET? My value is actually Labrador Retriever, so it does contain both of those. So I've created a statement here that says contains, and my value, my Labrador Retriever input, does it contain LAB? So that's my contains function that I've used here. And you can see when I hover over it, it says this is for an array. It also works for regular text. And then I'm saying, and does it contain RET? So I've got this and in here. You could also put an or in here. Those are found in your functions right over here. So you have and or. So you can use those in there. So I'm gonna run this and let's look and see what we have here. So contains lab and RET, it's true, all right? So now let's go down and look at our if-then statement. So I've taken this whole value, and the reason I've done this is because if you put a nested function inside if-then, there's a lot of things going on and it might be difficult to troubleshoot. So I'm starting with my statement, and I know it works correctly. And now I'm putting my statement inside my if-then statement. So right, if I hover over my if, you can see my if function pieces are underlined in blue. So between here and here is that statement above. So if this contains LAB and our value contains RET, then we want to output yes, it does. Otherwise, we want to output no, it doesn't. Okay, so this should be true and this should be yes, it does for our Labrador Retriever option. I'm going to run this here. All right, so I have Labrador Retriever in here. I'm going to run just this module. I'm going to hit OK. So does it contain LAB and RET true? And our output from our if statement says yes, it does. Now, if I right click on this and I say run this module only and I say thread redstone and run this. So does this contain LAB and RET false? So when I go down here to our if-then statement, it says no, it doesn't. So again, if we go back in here, if all of this is false, we're going to output no, it doesn't. So that is how the if function works for conditional logic in your make scenarios. All right, so now let's jump over to a similar one that I use quite a bit, probably as much or more than the if statement, is if empty. So what I've done here is I've set some variables, and I've said first value equals first value, second value is blank, third value equals third value, all right? So we're going to say, I'm going to save this, and right over here, I've got my variable name is if first empty second. So what I've done is, let me just get rid of this. I'm going to remap this. I'm going to go to my general functions and I'm going to click if empty. And so I'm going to back up here. I'm going to say if empty and I want to map a value. So if my first value is empty, I'm going to bump my cursor over one where I'm right there. I want to output the second value. All right. And in our case, the first value is not empty. The second is empty. So I'm going to save this and let's go ahead and run that. So again, our first value is called first value. Our second value is blank. So we should expect to get the first value here because we said if the first is empty, put the second. The first was not empty. So we have the first value there. Now, let's go over here and look at this one, because if I look at my source data, my second value is empty and my third has text. So right here, I'm evaluating if the second's empty, put the third. And what I have here is the third value, because in my if empty, my second value right here, I said if this one's empty, and it is, replace it with the third value. Now, where might this function be useful? I've got some scenarios recently with clients where we're actually looking up data. If it's blank here, then we can look up in another table and find that piece of data or that record ID and bring it back. So I'm just saying, hey, if you can't find it here, let's go look elsewhere and let's put it in the if empty function. Okay, let's talk about one more option for conditional logic in your make scenarios. So I have some variables set here, and I have something called switch value. That's my variable, and it's going to be a 2. So over here, when I click on this, there is a function called switch. And this is what it looks like. Basically, the switch says, if I give you one value, I want you to switch it to another value. If I give you a second value, I want you to switch it to that second value. So basically what the switch does is it says, if I give you a value, I want you to switch that value to something else every time. So this is what that looks like. So I'm going to actually back over all of this, and we're going to map this. And if you go to the general functions, you'll find that switch function. And it can be a little confusing, but basically the first thing you're going to do is put in your variable you want to evaluate. So I'm going to put my switch value variable right here. That always goes first. And then I'm just going to do value one result pairs. So you can see in our help right here, we have value one result one, value two result two on, and the last one can be an else. So I'm going to say one, go over here and say one. I'm going to switch the number one to the spelled out one. So I'm going to go to semicolon. I'm going to put another pair, two, semicolon, two, three, semicolon, three. All right. So what I'm saying is, if it's a number one, switch it to the word one. If it's a number two, switch it to the word two. If it's a number three, switch it to the word three. And if it's something else, we're just going to say something else. All right. That is our else statement in this case. All right, so let's play around with this. I'm going to save that and let's run this. And remember, I have a number two there. So if I run this, I get the word two here. And that's because I did an input of the number two, and our switch turned the number two into the word two. Okay, if I go back over here and do a one, save that and run it, I get the word one here. So the switch function is really good for when you have small pieces of data that you need to switch. If you have large amounts of data that you need to switch, like paragraph text, or I'm even doing a project right now where I take an ID and I turn it into a full HTML email that can be used in another step. In those cases, I will use the switch module. It does the same thing as the switch function, except it's a little easier again to put longer text in. So I have my switch value up here, and here's my pattern, one, and then I have a paragraph about the number one. One is a fun number, just one single digit, etc. And then I'm going to go down here and I have two, and here is my two paragraph, and here is three, four, and five. And then down here, we have that else value that we can do. And I'm going to output just else value if in the case that our input isn't 1 through 5. So I'm going to save that and let's run this. And our switch value was number one. So we should have a paragraph about the number one. Yep, there it is. The other thing you'll get down here is you get an output that says is else. And this is a true false Boolean output. I've never really used this, but I thought it would be helpful to know if this is an else value, meaning it didn't find it and it output the else option. And you might need to do something downstream in your scenario to fix that if that's the case. All right, so let's go back over here. I'm just going to run this one once and let's put in three. And there is our three paragraph right there. And let's right click and run this only and let's put in seven. Okay. And you can see our output is else value. So we only put in a 1 through 5 option. This is the else. And right here it says, is else true? Because it did not find a value and it output our else option. Those are both very helpful. The switch function and the switch module can be very helpful when building your scenarios in having that if-then conditional logic. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If then conditional logic can be a bit of a dry subject, But if you're still watching, I appreciate that. And I hope this video has helped you with your make scenarios. Leave me a comment below, a thumbs up. And if you want to learn more about functions with make, check out this playlist and you can subscribe to my channel right here. Thank you for watching and I will see you next time.